Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2107, split each worksheet to a new workbook. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. I've known in the back of my head that I've needed to do this for a long time, but two recent podcasts really brought it home. Just recently in episode 2106, where we were creating a PDF from all slicer combinations. Late in that episode, I showed an alternate method where we create many pivot reports, but it puts them all in the same workbook. And I got an email from Joe in California. He says, well, look, I need to send each worksheet to a different customer. And same thing, in my live Power Excel seminars, when I show that trick, people say, well, no, we don't want it all in the same workbook. We want it separately. Right? And then probably even more important than that, is back in episode 2077, where I talked about how Power Query now has the ability to combine all of the Excel files in a folder, right? And this is miraculous. It works great. If you had 400 Excel files, each with a single worksheet, it will grab all that data from all those worksheets and put it in one grid, which is awesome. But if we had almost the same problem, one workbook with 400 worksheets, it can't do it, right? It can't deal with that yet. Right, so right now, July 1st, 2017, it can't deal with that. Maybe in 6 months it can deal with that, but right now it has to be single sheet workbooks. So we need a way to be able to break things out into individual files. Okay, so let's just set this up. We have the workbook that I did in 2106, where we have the data and then the original pivot table, and we go into Analyze, Options, Show Report Filter Pages, and Show All Pages of the Key, and it creates a whole bunch of different worksheets for me, and I want to take those worksheets and create each one as a separate file. But even though we have that, there's some stuff like Sheet 2 and Data that I don't want to split, right? And of course, for every single person, that stuff, that list of worksheets that we don't want to split is going to be different, but I'm going to guess that almost everyone has some worksheets that they don't want to split. All right, so here's the utility that you're going to be able to download, the Mr. Excel Worksheet Splitter. And over here, I have a section in column B, and it's really the only thing in column B where you can list those worksheets that you don't want to split. It can be more than two. You can fill as many in here as you want. You can insert new rows. And my cheap way, I didn't want to have to loop through these in the macro. So far outside of your view out here, I have a spot where the macro can write the current worksheet name and then a simple little VLOOKUP that says, hey, go look for this worksheet that we're working on right now. See if it's over in column B. And if it is, we'll know that that's one that we don't want to export. All right, and then again, just to make this as generic as possible, I have several named ranges here. My path, my prefix, my suffix, my type, and my paste. All right, so you figure out where you want this stuff to go. C colon backslash reports, the final backslash. I want every file to have the sheet name, but before the sheet name, I'm going to put the prefix of WB, file suffix, and nothing. And then you have a choice here, PDF or XLSX. So we're going to start off with the XLSX. We'll talk about this paste values before saving later. All right, and right now this is version July 1st, 2017, the first one. If we improve this, I'll just replace it out on the web page. And you can find the web page down there in the YouTube descriptions. All right, so here's how this is going to work. It's an XLSM file, so you have to make sure that macros are allowed. Alt-T-M-S for security. You have to be at least at this level or below. All right, if you're at the top one, you need to change it, close the workbook, reopen. When you open the workbook, it's going to say, hey, are you willing to accept the macros here? And it's not a big macro at all, 68 lines of code, and a lot of that is just dealing with getting the values off the menu sheet, you know, what are the variables. The important thing here, though, is that it's going to work on the active workbook. So you're going to switch to the workbook that has the data and then press Control Shift S to run it. And it's going to detect the active workbook, and that's going to be the one that it splits out. It grabs my path, and just because I always forget to put that final backslash, if the last character is not a backslash, then I'm going to add a backslash. And then down here, this is the actual work for each worksheet in the original, in the active workbook dot worksheets. We're going to test to see if it's one that's over there in column B. If it's not, then we're going to export that sheet. And I love this line of code. WS.copy says we're going to take this workbook, this worksheet from this big workbook with, you know, 20 or 400 worksheets, and we're going to WS.copy, which makes a copy of it and moves it to a new workbook. workbook. And we know that that new workbook will now become the active workbook in the macro. And of course, there's only one sheet in that workbook, and that sheet is the active sheet. So right here, I can figure out the name of the workbook, set it, apply it to this object variable, workbook new, worksheet new, right? And then later on, when I have to close, I can do wbn.close after I've done the work. We figure out the new file name using all of the variables, kill that file if it already exists, and then if it's an Excel file, we do a save as. If it's a PDF, and by the way, this PDF code only works in Windows. If you're on a Mac, I'm sorry, you're going to have to go somewhere else to figure out the equivalent Mac code. I don't have a Mac. I know there's a way to save a PDF on a Mac. I know the code is different. You'll have to figure that one out, or you know, come back to the real Excel in Windows. And then when we're done, we close, all right? So just a simple little macro like that. Switch over to our data workbook here, the one that has all the worksheets. There's 20 different worksheets here, plus the two I don't want to do. And then Control Shift S, like this. And we'll watch it flash as it creates each one. There we are, 21 files created. Let's go take a look in Windows Explorer. And here's my C colon reports. It created for each worksheet name in the original workbook. It created a new version with WB up front. All right, now, Joe, when Joe sent me this note, he said that he's going to send this data to customers. And I kind of panicked at first because I said, well, wait a second, Joe, we're going to have a problem because you're going to send Gary his data, right? But this is, a live data set. It's a live pivot table. All of the stuff in here, you might be able to get all the information for other customers like that, right? Boy, you don't want to send customer A the information for all of the other customers. That could be a hassle. And then actually, when I reread Joe's note, he was smarter than me because he said, oh, no, I want to create them as PDF files. And I was like, all right, well, then, yeah, we don't have to worry about it as PDF files. That's fine. But what I added in here to the macro was the ability to say paste values before saving, true. So you set that equal to true, and that's going to invoke this tiny little bit of code here, where we say if paste v, then the usedRange.copy and then usedRange.paste special XL paste values. UsedRange, rather than copying and pasting all 17 billion cells, it'll limit it down to just the used range. All right, so let's switch back. Switch to the worksheet that has the data, Control Shift S for split. And then this new version in the reports directory, you'll see that it has gotten rid of the pivot table and left just the data there, so that way they can't get to all data. All right, we'll try the other feature. We'll try if we switch from Excel to PDF, change the prefix to PDF file of whatever you want there, and we'll even try the suffix. Something. All right, and then switch to the data, Control Shift S. All right, so we get the same files, PDF file of the worksheet name, something.pdf, and we should have just nice little PDFs in there like that. All right, so there you have it, the MrExcel.com worksheet splitter, hopefully generic enough for whatever you need. Download it again from the link there in the YouTube comments. To learn more about VBA, check out this book, Excel 2016 VBA Macros by myself and Tracy Sierstad. Click that I in the top right-hand corner to read more about the book. Joe from California, plus a lot of others, have asked for a way to save each worksheet to a different file, either as a PDF in Joe's case or as an Excel file, in case you're going to use Power Query to combine files. So created a nice little generic freeware utility out there. You can download and give it a shot. I want to thank Joe for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.